Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Foreign Correspondents Club of Japan. My name is Khaldun Azhari. I am the president of this club. I have the honor to welcome you and welcome our very important guest this morning. It's very good and impressive that you came in this big number despite the big news at 5:58 this morning. There was a missile over Japan, and I think this is causing a lot of attention, but we still have here good attention, and we will have some statements from our guest, most likely about this issue political case. Of course, we are here today to witness the debate between the two main candidates for the post of the president of Democratic Party of Japan, and each one will speak for 10 minutes, and then that will be followed by questions and answers. Let me introduce my guest. To my very right is Mr. Seiji Maehara. He's a former foreign minister, and he had many important posts at the Democratic Party in the past, and he was instrumental in making very important decisions over the security issues, and he's known of making also important and very kind of controversial issues about the security policies, and described by some journalists that it's close to the LDP policies. In the other side, he's also having his own way of thinking, and that fits the Democratic Party of Japan, who is struggling to seize power from the Jimminto Party. To his right, of course, our second guest, Mr. Edano. He's Yukio Edano. He's the former Secretary General of the Democratic Party, and also he assumed many big positions in the government of Minshito. Most important, I think, is the Meiti Minister, Ministry of Economy, Trade and Industry. He was in charge of the energy policy of Japan, and he also was very well known during the Fukushima crisis, giving briefings every day to the people, and he was at the head of the news all the time. And today, I think they will talk about their main policy and also about the new party that they promised to establish if either of them wins. Ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, please welcome our guest speaker today. Thank you.
おはようございます。
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen.
民進党代表候補の前原誠二でございます。
My name is Seiji Maehara. I'm one of the candidates for the presidency of the Democratic Party.
トータルで10分通訳を入れていただきますので、5分程度実際にはお話をさせていただきたいと思います。
I have been given 10 minutes, including the translation, so in essence, my talk will be for about 5 minutes.
まずは、今朝6時前に北朝鮮がミサイルを日本北海道えりも岬上空を越えて、太平洋に着弾するミサイルを発射をしました。
Yes, shortly before 6 a.m. this morning, North Korea launched a missile which flew over Japan's Hokkaido Cape Erimo, reaching the Pacific Ocean.
現在のところ、航空機、船舶に対する被害は報告されておりませんけれども、ひとたび間違えば重大な事案になる可能性があり、また日本の上空を通過したということは、ミサイル発射が失敗をすれば日本に落下する危機もあったということで、許しがたい暴挙であります。
And well, currently we have not received any reports of any damages done onto either aircrafts or vessels. But it is true that had it been that because it was flying over Japan, that in itself is a grave incident. And had it fallen on Japan, then this would have become a major crisis. So this is an incident which can never be forgiven.
厳しく北朝鮮の行為に対して抗議をするとともに、国連決議違反であり、しっかりと国際社会と連携をして北朝鮮に対する強いメッセージを与えるということを日本政府は率先して行うべきであります。
And therefore, the Japanese government should lodge a strong protest against North Korea. Likewise, it should refer to the UN resolutions and collaborate with the international community and send out a strong message to North Korea.
まあ、カリン代表に就任した後においてもこの問題については、これは日本の国益に関わる問題であり、まあ、しっかりと野党という立場でありますけれども、政府に対して協力をすべきところは協力をするというスタンスで臨みたいと考えております。
And if I am elected president of the Democratic Party in regards to this issue, because the Japanese national interest is at stake, as an opposition party representative, I would like to, where possible, cooperate with the government.
今回代表選挙に立候補させていただいた、まあ、大きな理由は、自民党に代わる新たな社会像を民進党がしっかり示すべきであり、その先頭に立たせていただきたいという思いであります。
And the reason why I decided to run in the presidential election is, the major reason is that I thought that the Democratic Party should present a new form or a new image of society which cannot be provided by the LDP. I wanted to provide an alternative to the LDP.
確かに、戦後特に高度経済成長期には、自民党の、まあ、小さな政府、そして、公共投資、減税、これが好循環を生んで、日本の発展を後押しをしたという面はあったと思います。
Now, it is true that after the war of Japan, during especially the high economic growth period, the LDP's policies, namely small government and public investment and tax cutting, did create a virtuous cycle supporting the development.
まあ、しかし、特にバブルが崩壊して以降、日本の成長は鈍化をし、そして国民所得は減少を続けました。
However, after the bubble bursted, then the Japan's growth started to slow down, and people experienced a decline in their income.
アベノミクスという、まあ、言ってみれば最後の壮大な実験によって財政出動、そして異次元の金融緩和、これでなんとかもう一度失われた成長を取り戻そうというのが安倍総理のチャレンジだったと思います。
And for that reason, the Abenomics was introduced, the last largest experiment, I should say, mobilizing a fiscal spending and trying to realize an unprecedented easing of monetary easing. And this is an attempt to restore the growth that was experienced in the past.
まあ、確かに、金融緩和が特に効果を発揮をして、金利は下がり、そして他国との金利差が広がる中で円安がもたらされ、そして株価は上がり、企業の利益は増えました。
Well, in terms of the financial easing, yes, it is proving to be effective. In other words, we have witnessed as a result the decline in the interest rate, and there is a bigger gap between the interest rates of countries leading to a weaker yen, and we have seen the share prices increase and the corporate profit as well increase.
しかしこの金融緩和、異次元の金融緩和というのは持続可能性があるわけではありません。出口の議論は、まだできないどころか永遠にできない可能性すらあります。
And well, this monetary easing yet is not sustainable, and yet they have not started the discussion on the exit strategy. It might be that they will never be able to discuss any exit strategy.
また株価を上げるためにはなりふり構わず、GPIF のポートフォリオを変更して24% から 50% の株に対する運用を、強化し、また日銀は、国債のみならず、ETF を買い続けるということで、株価を、押し上げるということをなりふり構わず行っているのが今の政府と日銀であります。
And also in order to boost the share prices, the government is taking drastic measures without much thinking. For example, the GPIF, the portfolio, they're investing 24% to 50% now into shares and stocks. And also they're investing not only into the government bonds, but also BDF. And therefore, I think that the measures that they're taking are reckless.
確かに労働人口の減少などもあり雇用環境は改善をしておりますけれども、しかし2012年の第4四半期、景気の谷と言われた時と比べると賃金は同程度であり、企業の利益というものはかなりの多くの部分が内部留保に溜まっていっている状況であります。
And it is true that due to the decline in the workers' population and the number of workers, we are seeing the employment situation improve. But however, if we were to compare the current situation against 2012 quarter four, which was thought to be at the bottom of the decline in the economy, we see that the wage rate is approximately the same level. And also much of the corporate profit is being retained inside the companies.
その結果として今や先進国の中でも相対的貧困率は高くなり、特に一人親家庭の相対的貧困率は先進国最悪 50.8% という現状であります。
And as a result, we see that if we were to compare Japan to the industrialized nations overseas, and we see that the relative poverty rate is very high, and also in terms of the divorce rate, especially the single parent families, it is as much as 50.8%.
お年寄りは世界でも一番の長寿国になりましたけれども、年金が減らされ、介護の仕組みに不安を感じています。
And we are seeing an aging of our society. Japan enjoys the longest longevity, yet these older persons are seeing their pension payment go down, and they are anxious about the nursing care mechanism that is in place here in Japan.
非正規雇用が4割にもなり、若い人たちの中には結婚したくても結婚ができない。仮に結婚したとしても希望の子供数を持てない状況が生まれ、それがひいては日本の構造問題である少子化、人口減少、活力のない地域というものが生まれる原因となっています。
And so as a result, we see that there are as many as 40% non-regular workers, and those are people, though even though they wish to marry, cannot marry, and even if they were to marry, they could not have the number of children that they would normally want to have. And as a result, we are seeing that Japan is faced with this low fertility and depopulation problem, and many areas are seeing depopulation occurring.
私が提唱するオール・フォー・オールという考え方は、トリクルダウン型の今の、いわゆる経済政策ではなくて、ボトムアップ、つまりはすべての人たちの、命と尊厳を保障し、そして好循環をもたらすという、全く逆の方向の再分配強化政策であります。
And so the policy that I'm advocating is all for all. And unlike the trickle-down policy, this is a bottom-up policy. We want to respect the lives and also dignity of all people and thereby create a virtuous cycle. This is the opposite of what is happening today. It's a totally different redistribution policy.
中福祉、中負担の国を目指す。今の国民負担率は日本は 42.5%、 1000兆円を超える借金を勘案したとしても、まだ 50% にいかない状況であり、中口中負担の国家は今なら作れる、遅くない。それをしっかりと自民党の対立軸として民進党の政策に位置づけるために、代表として、リードしていきたい、こう考えております。
And I believe that we need to try to establish a country where people can enjoy a middle level welfare, and also the burden that is imposed on the people in terms of the welfare should be also middle level. Currently, the people's burden ratio is 42.5%, and even if we were to service the 1,000 trillion debt that exists, it will not reach 50%. And therefore, I think that is not too late late for us at this point in time to try to achieve this middle level welfare and middle level burden state. And I think that the Democratic Party should be an alternative to the LDP to try to make this proposal. And as if I am elected president, I would like to lead this effort.
ありがとうございました。
Thank you.
おはようございます。民進党代表選挙に立候補した枝野幸男です。
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Yukio Edano. I am the other candidate for the Democratic Party presidential election.
私も今朝ほどの北朝鮮による弾道ミサイル発射については、具体的な被害が出なかったからと いいようなものとは言える話ではない。大変な危険なを伴うものであり、またこうした挑発行為というものは東アジア、あるいは太平洋地域の安全にとっての大きな脅威であり、断固抗議するものであります。
Yes, and also from my side, in regards to the North Korean missile launch, a ballistic missile launch, it is not acceptable to say that just because there were no damages recorded, this can be tolerated. And no way can this be accepted, and it is a serious danger. Such provocative action will pose a threat to East Asia and the Pacific region, and therefore there is a need to lodge a strong protest against North Korea.
こうした挑発に対しては、日米同盟を中心として関係諸国との連携を深め、また我が国自身が専守防衛の範囲の中で自衛力防衛力を高めていく中で毅然とした対応を取っていくべきであると考えておりまして、こうしたリアルな具体的な安全保障論については今の自民党と大きな差のあるものではないということを特に外国のメディアの皆さんにまず申し上げたいと思います。
Yes, and when it comes to such provocative action, I think I'm centered around the US-Japan alliance. Japan should be cooperating with all countries involved, and Japan would adhere to their defense-only policy, but within this framework, Japan should try to strengthen its self-defense, defense capabilities, and stand up to such a provocative action. This is a real threat, and in the face of real threat, and when it comes to the discussion on security, I'm not much different from what is being said by the LDP, and I would like to state this to the foreign press, which are represented here.
外交安全保障に限らず政治一般にも言えると思いますが、足元でリアルに現実を前に何をするべきかという話と、もう一つは将来に向けて何を目指していくかと、政治は両面が大事だと思っています。
Now, this is not limited to just diplomacy or security issues, but in terms of politics in general, on the one hand, we have to focus on what is happening now, the reality that we see here today. But at the same time, we should be looking towards the future and what we should be aiming towards the future. So I think that politics has these two sides.
この点で、日本が唯一の被爆国であるということ、あるいは第二次世界大戦に関連する時代の過去の歴史や教訓というものを踏まえたときに、我が国は核拡散防止や平和構築という分野で国際の社会の中で大きな役割を果たしていくという、こうした将来に向けた方向性というものが、特にここ10年ぐらいの間、自民党の中で著しく弱まっていると、ここに対して明確な対抗軸を打ち立てていきたいと思っています。
Now, so looking at the situation, first of all, Japan is the only country which has suffered from A-bombs. And also after the war, and during the war, we have had some lessons learned in terms of our past history. So based on these lessons, Japan should be taking the initiative to promote non-proliferation, non-nuclear proliferation, and peace building in the international community. And I think that this is the major role that Japan should play, beplaying towards the future. But over the past 10 years or so, the LDP's awareness and position in regards to these issues have weakened significantly.
はい、その上で、内政問題について何点かお話したいと思いますが、経済社会の方向性という点については、 前原さんのおっしゃったことと非常に近いんですが、若干のニュアンスの違いを申し上げたいと思います。
Now, having said that, I would like to turn my eyes to the domestic politics and say a few things in regards to first the social and economic aspects. As for the future direction, what I'm saying is quite similar to what Mr. Maeharas is saying, there is a slight difference in nuance.
日本の経済が長期にわたって低迷している原因は消費不況、消費が減っているということにあると思っています。したがって今日本の経済の上で一番大事なことは消費を拡大させることだと思っています。
Now, the reason why Japan has suffered over a long period of time a sluggish economy is due to the low consumption. I think that the economic problems that Japan is facing is due to the low consumption and we have to try to increase consumption.
消費が冷え込んでいる原因は労働法制の間違った緩和、それを伴って、いわゆる中産階級が減って、低賃金で、不安定な働き方のワーカーが著しく増えたということにあります。
Now, and the reason why we see this significant decline in consumption is due to the labor legislation. Because of the mistaken easing of the regulations, we have seen a decline in the middle class in Japan. As a result, there are a number of low wage workers and working in very unstable conditions. And so this can be attributed to this problem.
したがって、安定的な雇用を取り戻す、これは制度改革に伴って時間がかかります。もう一つは、今現に低賃金の皆さんの賃金をどう上げるかというところにあります。
And so there is a need to bring about stable employment system, but such reform will require time. In the meantime, we have to think about how we can increase the low wages of these workers.
実は日本には需要がありながら、低賃金であるために、人手不足で供給が不足をしているという分野が多々あります。
Now, in Japan, there are many sectors in which there is a demand for manpower due to the low wages. People are reluctant to work, and therefore there's a shortage of labor.
典型が保育士と介護職員です。
And a typical example would be the child caregivers and the nursing caregivers.
いずれも広い意味での公的な資金がその人件費の財源になっています。
And in many of these cases, a large part of their wages is funded by public funds in terms of the broad definition.
景気対策として公的なお金を突っ込むなら、申し訳ありませんが、海外からの輸入代金に支払われる原材料費に使うよりも、こうした低賃金の皆さんの給料にあった方が、よほど経済波及効果は大きいと。
And so if you were to introduce pump priming measures and invest public money, then I think, excuse me for saying this, but rather than spending on the importation of raw materials from overseas, I think it would be much better to use this money to increase the wages of these people so as to improve the economy.
こうした需要不足の公的サービスの人件費に公的資金を移していくことは経済対策として効果的であると同時に我々が目指す私の言葉では支え合いの社会に向けてもつながっていく今最優先でやるべき課題だと思っています。
And so as I'm saying there are these shortages of manpower in these sectors and if we were to inject public money into such sectors it would not only beA pump priming measure, but at the same time would lead to the realization of the society which I am advocating, a society where people support each other. And therefore, I regard this as the top priority agenda item.
最後に2点だけ自民党との大きな違いを短く触れたいと思いますが、一つは情報公開と公文書管理、報道の自由です。
And lastly, I'd like to say two things which are different from the LDP, and that is in terms of the information disclosure and also freedom of the press, as well as the disclosure of public information.
一部の調査では、 先進国の中で最も報道の自由度が低いと言われているような状況を変えると、これは我々でなければできないことだと思っています。
And、some of the surveys show that amongst the developed nations and Japan's freedom of the press、is the lowest ranking amongst others and、therefore this is something that we only、can bring about change in。
もう一つは少数者の人権の問題です。
And the other is、the protecting the human rights of minorities.
まあ、先進国共通して社会が分断をされるという社会問題を抱えています。日本でもいわゆるヘイトスピーチなど、日本に住む外国人の一部の皆さんに対する差別、そして日本人同士の間においてもハンディキャップを負っている皆さん、性的少数者、さまざまなところで差別、人権に対するさまざまな迫害が残念ながらこの先進国で存在しています。
And、so、we see that、well, worldwide、there is、this problem of、the division of society. And、likewise in Japan, we are hearing hate speeches being made towards, for example, the foreigners living in Japan. And also there are discriminatory remarks、being made even amongst、the Japanese、towards those people who、havehandicaps and also the sexual minorities、to name a few、so I think、that unfortunately even in Japan、there are、such oppressive discriminatory、statements、violation of human rights taking place。
こうした課題に政府として政治が積極的に取り組むことで多様性を認め合う社会を政治として、促していくと、分断を解消させていくと、そのことにリーダーシップを発揮したいと思っています。
And、I believe、that politicians、should be、taking proactive measures、to、try to recognize each other's diversity and as a politician、try、to、alleviate and、remedy、this division in society and we should be taking the leadership to make this happen。
ありがとうございました。
Thank you。
Thank you very much for these insights and、we open the floor to your questions. We will let、first the journalist and the、regular member of this club ask questions.、please proceed to the front、when you are.
では質疑応答に移りたいと思います。まずは政界員、ジャーナリストから。
Please ask one question. Anthony. Next one.
一問ずつ。
Anthony Hurley, Singapore Business Times.、both speakers have taken what I might call a stern attitude towards North Korea's latest、missile、firing、and allied yourselves with the position of the government and the LDP.、but it seems to me that no one has an independent initiative to try to improve dialogue with North Korea. So do you, Maya Harrison, or you have an idea that if you indeed move into power at some point, you will try to initiate dialogue directly with North Korea so that this impasse, which seems to be getting worse from week to week, day to day, can be overcome?、Mm-hmm.
はい、ビジネスタイムズものでございますけれども、2人とも北朝鮮への今朝のミサイル発射に関しては断固たる態度で臨むというご発言を頂戴いたしましたけれども、まあ、そしてまた、この与党、自民党政権と同じ立場を取られるというお話があったんですけれども、どなたも、その直接的な北朝鮮との対話を持つ、まあ、対話を通じて北朝鮮との関係改善を図るというようなご発言はございませんでした。2人のいずれか、例えばもし、その民進党が政権を取ったならば北朝鮮と直接対話をするというような可能性について、そして日々そして毎週この膠着状態が悪化する中でこういった問題を解消できるような道筋というのは考えられていないんでしょうか。
ありがとうございます。私は外務大臣の時に日朝の対話というものを行っておりました。
Thank you very much for the question. When I was foreign minister, I was engaged with dialogue with North Korea.
まあこれは小泉政権の時に拉致問題解決のために日朝間で作られた外交ルートというのが残っておりましたので、そのルートでの議論を重ねておりました。
And this was during the days of the Koizumi administration, and in those days we still had、this channel、between、China,、rather、Japan and、North Korea, and in regards、to resolving、the issues with North Korea.
まあ、私はこういった対話というのは、まあ、正式な外交ルートでやることが、特に北朝鮮のような国では一番正しいのだというふうに思っています。
And I personally think that such dialogue through official channels, diplomatic channels with North Korea is the best way to try to resolve these problems.
それは現在米朝間で水面下で対話が行われているかもしれないということと連動する意味においても、正式な外交ルートというもの、これは日米も含めてでありますけれども、大事な意見交換の場になりうると思っています。
And I think that also there is the possibility that behind the scene of the United States and North Korea may be holding dialogue. So in connection with that also I think that is important that we go through official diplomatic channels including the US and Japan working together. So I think that this will be an important opportunity to exchange views.
現在我々は北朝鮮に対する制裁を行っておりまして、国としてなかなか対話があるいは人的交流ができないというのが現状であります。
However, currently the reality is that there are a number of sanctions imposed against North Korea and therefore it is very difficult to hold such dialogues or have exchanges between people.
それゆえ等間交流というのもなかなか限界があるのではないかと思います。
And therefore, I think that there will be a limit to the exchanges that can take place between the two countries.
まあ、しかし、先ほど申し上げたことを前提としつつも、対話と圧力でありますので、対話を模索するということも、まあ、しっかりやっていかなくてはいけないのではないかと思います。
But still, having said that, based on the premises that I've already described, I think that it is important to both search for and seek for measures to, on the one hand, hold dialogue, on the other hand, to impose pressure. And so we need to search for means to hold dialogues.
対話の重要性を否定するものではありませんが、まあ、今の状況で、日本が対話を強調するような局面ではないと私は思っています。
Of course, I do not deny the importance of holding such dialogues, but at this point in time, I do not think that this is the time to emphasize the importance of dialogue.
まあ、まあ、相手が対話を通じて、いわゆる挑発などをやめる、核ミサイル開発などにブレーキがかかるという可能性、余地があるのかどうか、そしてそこに向けては、日本が単独で対話をするということではなくて、アメリカや中国など関係諸国が、まあ、水面下含めてどういう状況になっているのか、まあ、そうした全体の構造の中で対話の意義がある場合、ない場合というのをしっかりと見極めていかなければならないと思います。
And I think that having said that, we have to look into whether there is room to hold dialogue in order to suppress or prevent the nuclear and missile development that North Korea is promoting. And we also have to think about not holding dialogues by Japan alone, but also consulting with the United States, China, and other stakeholders, and including the possibilities of these countries holding talks with North Korea behind the scenes. So we have to look at the total picture and judge whether it is meaningful or not to have such dialogues with North Korea.
現状、米朝間、あるいは中国と北朝鮮の間、さらには日本政府が水面下でどのようなことをしているのか、野党として知る立場にありませんし、これは外に向かって、オープンにしながらやることではないと思っています。だから現状の北朝鮮の挑発が繰り返されている状況では、そうした状況を知らない我々の立場が、対話を強調すると北朝鮮に対する間違ったメッセージになると私は思っています。
And I think that looking at the current situation, be it United States and North Korea or China and North Korea or the Japanese government, we, because we are on the opposition side, we do not really know what is happening behind the scene. We are not in position to know such things, and therefore I don't think it is appropriate to say to the outside world that this is happening or not. And looking at the consensusSituation where North Korea is continuing to take such a provocative action and not knowing what is happening behind the scenes, I do not think that is appropriate for us here to say whether dialogues are appropriate or not.
Thank you, Robin. and Gebhardt later.
Robin Harding from the Financial Times. The economic policy you both lay out, you're somewhat critical of the government on the sustainability and exit strategy for its policy. You want a fairer distribution, or you want more for workers. This policy seems basically identical to every other recent Democratic Party leader, Ms. Renho, Mr. Okada. And in all cases, it's been rejected by the Japanese people, and the Democratic Party has made no progress against the LDP. So why will it be different this time under your leadership if you're following the same policies as your previous leaders who gained no traction with the public? Thank you.
フィナンシャルタイムズのハーティングでございますけれども、2人の経済政策についてちょっとお聞きしたいというふうに思います。2人とも現在の政権が取っている経済政策を批判されました。これは持続可能ではない、しかも出口が見えないなどということをおっしゃったんですけれども、そしてそれに対して民進党としては公平な分配、労働者の支援等を行っていくというようなことをおっしゃっております。ただおっしゃった内容というのはいずれも、最近の民進党代表、岡田代表、そして蓮舫代表と何ら変わらないのではないかというふうに思いますし、これらの主張に関してはこれまで国民も決して交換をしておりません、ということで全くその民進党として、自民党に対して進展が見られない中、同じことを主張しているということで、今回、もし代表になれた場合、これまでとどういった点が違うのか、どうもこれまでと全く変わらないような内容に聞こえてなりませんが、いかがでしょう。
ありがとうございます。私は今までの民進党の政策とは、基本的に違う、提案をしているつもりであります。
Well, thank you very much for the question. I believe that what I am proposing isTotally different, fundamentally different from the policies that the Democratic Party has been taking in the past.
例えば中苦し中負担ということを明確に今まで言ったことはありませんし、オールフォールというのはみんなが受益者になると同時にみんなが応分の負担をし合うということを明確にするものであります。
For example, I mentioned no one in the past, no representative in the past has said that Japan should be aiming towards a middle, middle welfare and middle burden sharing country. And the slogan that I'm putting out here, all for all, well, the meaning is that everyone will be a beneficiary, but at the same time, everyone would have to share the burden. And never has this been clearly stated.
しかも基本的な哲学が私は違うというふうに思っています。
And what's my thing, the basic philosophy is different.
例えば格差を是正するということについては、今まではお金持ちから、よりお金を、税金を、国民負担を、上げて、そして貧しい人に分配するという、そういう所得移転が、主でありました。
Now, when we talked about trying to rectify the disparity in income in the past, what people advocated was that we should increase the tax burden on the rich so that the money can be redistributed to the poor.
All for all というのは、所得に関係なくみんなが応分の負担をし、みんなが受益者になり、結果として格差が是正されるということであります。
However, all for all means that irrelevant to the income level of the individual, everyone becomes a beneficiary, and at the same time, everyone has to share the burden, and as a result, reduce the disparity.
このことによって、いわゆる所得の多い少ない人の間の分断をなくすというのが一つの考え方です。
And so as a result, one way of thinking is that we think that we can remedy the division between the haves and have-nots.
また、若い方々、そしてご高齢者の方々、また現役世代の方々、それぞれの世代に対する分配政策をしっかりとパッケージにして、世代間の分断をなくすという考え方もオールフォーオールの中核であります。
And another core way of thinking for the all for all is that we want to do away with the division amongst the different generations. In other words, the young people, the older persons, and the working age population.
また理解をいただけるようにこれからも粘り強く広報活動に努めてまいりたいと考えております。ありがとうございました。
And, I will work hard to do more PR so that people will fully understand this concept.
前原さんのおっしゃった理念には全く同意するんですが、私は今までと違うということについては別の側面だと思っていまして、
Yes, I concur with what Mr. Maiha is saying, and yet what is different, I think, is different from what he has described.
これまでも個別に提起してきた我々の政策というのは、あまり違ってないと言われればその通りかもしれません。
Well, yes, I'm looking at the policies that are being proposed this time individually. Yes, if you look at them individually, they might not appear to be very different from the past.
ただ、これが特に今一番重要な消費を増やすということに向けた大きな経済効果を持った景気対策でもあるんだということについてはしっかりと伝えてこなかったと私は思います。
However, I think that still given the fact that the biggest challenge for Japan is to increase its consumption, if we were to look at these measures as a pump priming measure, I think it will take on a new look and we have not been able to fully communicate this in the past.
正しい理念だから進めるというところが強調されすぎて景気対策という側面が伝わっていなかったために民進党には経済政策がない弱いという間違ったイメージをつけられてしまっていると思っています。
And, so we emphasize that this is the correct philosophy, way of thinking, but we failed to communicate this as a pump priming measure. And as a result, the Democratic Party was thought to be a party which had no or very weak economic policies.
したがってこれは将来の目指す社会につながる一歩であると同時にあるいはそれ以上に景気対策として有効なんだと自信を持って訴えることが重要だと思います。
And, therefore I think that what is important is for us to emphasize that it is true that on the one side it's the first step towards achieving the type of society that we are envisioning, but at the same time it should be looked at as one of the pump priming measures.
あともう一点、私の主張は今までと経済に関わるところで大きく違う。それは財政規律を取り戻すことは大変重要だけれども、今の経済状況で消費税を上げることはやりたくてもできない。ここを明確に打ち出したいと私は思っています。
And another thing which is different is that yes, I do recognize that fiscal discipline is important, but given the current economic situation, it is impossible to increase the consumption tax at this point in time, even if you wanted to do the tax hike.
Gebhard Hilscher, freelance from Germany. When you were government spokesman and Mr. Kanauto was prime minister, the terrible Fukushima tragedy occurred. But the current government, the Abe Neikaku, is again supporting starting new atomic plants or exporting atomic industry facilities to other countries, etc.You haven't said anything about it. The public is in Yoronchosa, inquiries, has a majority expressed themselves against nuclear energy. How do you feel about nuclear energy? Do you have any concrete policy of stopping it, of reducing it, or what is your view? Both of you, I'm asking. But of course, first, Mr. Edam.
私、ドイツのフリーランス記者でありますけれども、枝野さんが官房長官時代、当時、菅直人総理でありましたけど、福島の事故が発生をいたしました。で、安倍内閣はそれにもかかわらず、今、新たにまた原発を再稼働させる、そしてまた原子力施設を輸出しようとしているということに関して、何もご発言がございませんでした。国民の多くの人たちは原子力に反対でありますが、2人、最初は枝野さんからお願いしたいんですけども、原子力に関して具体的にどういった政策をお持ちでしょうか、やめるべきなのか、減らすべきなのか、どういったお考えでしょう。
はい、私は一刻も早く原発ゼロを実現をする、 そのことを明確に掲げ、そこに向けてやらなければならないことがたくさんあります。そのやらなければならないことをきちっとリストアップして工程表として示す、そのことを一刻も早く実現をしたい。それを示すことによって国民の皆さんも、原発ゼロはリアリズムだと、可能なんだということを感じていただける、そうした提案を代表になればできるだけ早くしたいと思っています。
Yes, and I, from my position, would like to see that the nuclear power plants be reduced to zero as early as possible. I have made this clear, my position, and there are a number of things that need to be achieved to make this happen. So we need to first list up the things that need to be done to achieve this goal and produce a roadmap. I think that we need to put together a roadmap as soon as possible and show to the public that phasing out and reducing to zero nuclear power plants is a real option. And I think that people will recognize that this is a reality that can be achieved. So once, if I am elected president, I would like to, as soon as possible, put together such a roadmap.
Hi, my name is Kim Iran from Pan Orient News. Given the recent huge loss that the Democratic Party experienced in the Tokyo elections, can you explain why exactly did the Democratic Party lose and why were those seats not gained by LDP but instead by the Tokyo First Party?
はい、すみません、まず都議選に関してなんですけれども、民進党大敗をいたしました、なぜ大敗したのかの理由と、そしてなぜこの失った議席が自民党ではなく都民ファーストに取られたのかについてご意見を頂戴したいと思います。
まず都民ファーストの会が躍進した理由はただ一つ、小池都知事の人気があったからだというふうに思います。
Yes, first of all, the reason why Tomin First did so well in the election was the only reason was the popularity of Governor Yuriko Koike.
彼女は国会議員のバッジを外して、通るかどうかわからない都知事選挙に出て、そして、見事に当選をし、例えばオリンピックの費用、例えば豊洲の問題について情報公開などをし、今まで知り得なかったことが明らかになった、それに対する一定の都民ならず国民の評価があるんだろうと思います。それが都民ファーストの躍進につながったと思います。
I think that the reason why she is so popular is because she decided to quit as a Diet member and run in the gubernatorial election, not knowing whether she can win the election or not. She took the risk and she won in the election. And since then, she has disclosed information which was not seen by the public in the past, such as the Olympic Games budget and also the issue of the Toyosu.Etc. And I think that not only the Tokyo people, but the public, the Japanese people, appraised her work efforts. And this is the reason why Tomin First did so well in the election.
あるメディアの調査によりますと、都民ファーストの支持率というのは自民党、民進党、維新の支持率が下がった分のほぼ合計だと言われています。
And so I think that the Tomin First seats, the approval rate is equal to the disapproval rate or the loss of the approval rate by the LDP, the DP, 民進党ともう一つなんですね。
維新。
And also the Japan Innovation Party.
まあ、政党の命というのはどういう社会を目指すべきなのか。まあ、今回の都議選で、民進党が、対立軸あるいは政策の基軸となるそういった、魅力を出せなかったことが私は最大の、民進党が議席を減らした理由であろうと思っています。
And I think that the biggest reason why the Democratic Party lost so many seats is because of the fact that what kind of society you aim to achieve needs to be clearly presented to the people. I think this is the lifeline of a political party. And yet the Democratic Party failed to present an appealing, contrasting vision. And that led to the defeat.
あの私は小池知事が登場してから都議選までの間、特にある段階まで民進党が小池知事にすり寄っているかのような印象を与えてしまった。これが、我々が想定以上に大きく議席を減らした原因だと思っています。
Well, I think that the reason why the Democratic Party lost to a greater extent than originally anticipated was because up until a certain period of time, during the time when Ms. Koike was elected governor to the election of the Tokyo Assembly, for a certain period of time, the DP, the Democratic Party, was thought to be trying to come close to Koike.
あの別に何でも敵視する必要はないわけですが、どういう政策でどういうふうな都知事としての運営をしていくのかがはっきりしていない段階で大きな人気があるということで、その人気にすがろうとしたという誤解を与えてしまった。こうしたこう軸のしっかりしていないという印象を与えてしまうと選挙では厳しい、こうした結果になった。しっかりとそんな中でも軸をぶらさず頑張ってきた仲間が議席をその結果として失ったことは大変残念だと思っています。
And so I think that though well, we don't have to be an adversary for everything, but still, I think even at that time when the governor had not made clear what her policies are, and also and at that point in time, it was not clear how she would be running the Tokyo government. And yet, even at that early stage, the people thought that Democratic Party members were trying to take advantage of our popularity and come close to Governor Koike. And this led, there were such misunderstandings. And as a result, of course, the public does not like politicians to change their positions depending on the circumstances. And therefore, as a result, we saw that very harsh, poor result of the election. And I feel it's very unfortunate that even those members who maintained their position were not influenced by the popularity of Governor Koike lost their seats in the election.
I'm going to ask questions in Japanese. ビデオニュースの神保です。前原さんと枝野さんはもう初当選時代からずっと同級生で一緒にやられてきているわけですけども、今回こういう形で代表選を争う形になってね、お二人の方向性とか考え方の違いというものも初めてはっきりとした。そこでですね、もしこの選挙もう今週末ですが終わった後、例えば枝野さんがおっしゃる、勝って枝野さんがおっしゃってるような路線を邁進した場合、前原さんはそれでもその党を支えていくのか、あるいは逆に前原さんが今この選挙戦で主張された方向性、主張、枝野さんの違う部分ですね、それを本当にストレートに実行した場合に、枝野さんはそれを支えるのか、ついていくのか、あるいはそういうことになればちょっと別の道というようなことも考えるのか、その辺を教えてください。
Yes, and well, the two of you have been close friends ever since you were first elected. You are like the alumni, having been elected at the same timing. So, and yet you are contending against each other in this election. And I think for the first time you've made clear your differences in the way of thinking and the direction that you are pursuing. Now, supposing after the election, well, for example, Mr. Edano is elected and he decides to follow his policies and head in the direction that he has been explaining, and then would Mr. Maihara still be willing to support him, and vice versa? versa. I'm supposing that Mr. Miyahara is elected and he decides to take the policies that he has been describing, asserting. Then with Mr. Edano, though you have different ways of thinking, will you be willing to support Mr. Miyahara, follow his footsteps, and or would you opt to take a different path?
ジェームさん、ありがとうございます。戦いに出てるということは、自分が負けることは想定をしておりません。
Well, thank you for the question. And the fact that I am running in this election, I'm not assuming that I will lose.
したがって、自分が負けた場合を想定してのご質問には、今その考えはないということで、ご理解をいただきたいと思います。
And therefore, because your question was assuming I might lose in the election, I have to respond that I'm not thinking of any such a possibility.
勝たせていただいた暁には、私が申し上げたことを基本的に党の意見として進めていきたいという思いはあります。
But once I win the election, the policies that I've just described, I would like to pursue them as the opinion of the party.
しかし、代表には独裁権はありません。
But of course, the president of the party is not a dictator.
しっかり党内で議論する中で、みんなが納得する形で、私が思い描いている社会像、そして党内ガバナンス、こういったものをしっかりと実現をしてまいりたいと、こう考えております。
And therefore, there needs to be full discussion within the party so that everyone is convinced and thereby everyone can head towards the kind of society that I've described and also realize the in-party governance that I am contemplating.
私は民進党を強くすることで、もう一度政権交代可能な軸を作ると、この姿勢はどういう状況になっても一貫して変わりません。
Yes, my position will remain unchanged no matter what the result is in terms of trying to make the Democratic Party stronger so that we will be an alternative to the current government and being able to achieve a change in government.
日本はフランスのような決選投票制度のない小選挙区制度が軸ですから、一定の幅のある2つの政党が競い合うという構造を作らなければならない。その中で今の民進党の幅、ましてや私と前原さんの幅、これぐらいの幅は当然一つの政党として戦っていかなければ、この選挙制度自体が成り立ちません。
Yes, and unlike France, where they have a presidential runoff election, in Japan, the basis is the single seat constituent system. And therefore, there needs to be a certain difference amongst the parties, and there needs to be a large party, major party structure to compete in the election. And therefore, I think the differences in view between Maihara-san and myself are well within the range that we can belong to the same.Party, the Democratic Party.
もう一つはやはり政権の担い手として安定的に政権を運営しようと思ったら全国津々浦々に一定の地域基盤を持つ、一時の風だけに乗るような政党では本当の政権の担い手足りえない。津々浦々に地域基盤を作るのには5年10年という単位がかかる、今の民進党の積み重ねを無にしてしまったら、また10年、20年、風頼みの政党しか自民党とは対抗にできなくなる。これでは日本の民主主義は進展しない。したがって民進党を強くする。このために全力を挙げます。
And so I think also in order to become a party which is capable of taking the realm, we need to have the capability to stably run the government, and meaning that we need to have a solid foundation through all parts of Japan. It's not the case where that party can just take advantage of popularity or boom in order to become a ruling party. And it takes 5 to 10 years to establish such strong foundations.Through all parts of Japan. And therefore, if we were to scrap everything that we have accumulated in the past, we will have to start again and spend maybe the next 10 or 20 years to build the foundation to become a party strong enough to take the helm. And we don't want to become a party which is relying on popularity or just booms at the time. And therefore, I will, no matter what the result is, work hard to make the Democratic Party a strong party.
Thank you. です。I would like to ask the question that has not been asked. What is your policy toward cooperation with the Communist Party in the next elections?
はい、共産党との共闘体制に関して、どういった、まあ、次回の選挙における共闘体制についての政策を聞かせてください。
もう1年3ヶ月以内には必ず総選挙があります。
Well, within the next year and three months, that is 15 months, there is going to be a general election for sure.
総選挙は政権選択の選挙です。
And the general election is an election to choose the government.
我々の基本的な理念、政策、考え方と異なるところとは政権を組むわけにはいきません。
And we cannot partner with any parties which have differences in terms of the basic philosophy, policy, or thinking.
また方で我々の理念、政策、考え方に共鳴をしていただけるところとは幅広く協力していくということ、そして、地域のさまざまな事情について当然ながら代表として一人でも多くの議員の当選のために努力をする、まあ、そういったことを、代表として努力をしていきたいと考えております。
Yes, and at the same time, if we see that that party shares the same think philosophy, policies, and thinking, we would be more than willing to broadly cooperate with that party or parties. And of course, naturally, as the president of the party, my role will be to enable as many of our candidates to win in the election and having knowledge about what is happening in the different parts of Japan. So as the president of the Democratic Party, I will work towards that end.
我々と共産党との間では、目指すべき社会像や政策の重要なポイントのいくつかで大きく異なっていますので、政権を共にするとか包括的な連携をするということは全く想定していない。まずこれを最初に申し上げたいと思います。
Well, the outset, I would like to make clear that when it comes to collaborating with the Japanese Communist Party, we recognize that there are major differences, big differences in on important issues regarding the society that we aim to achieve and also various policies. And therefore, we are not, I emphasize, not contemplating becoming a coalition with the Communist Party, nor are we considering comprehensive collaboration with such parties.
一方で、政治はベストを目指しながらより増しを選択していくということの中で、今の国民の中にとにかく今の自民党の暴走にブレーキをかける歯止めをかける野党第一党としてその役割をしっかり果たすことの期待もあります、我々の理念政策を揺るがす、ことない範囲の中でできるだけ多くの皆さんの支持理解を得られるために難しさは困難はたくさんあるけれども最大限の努力をして一人でも多くの仲間を当選させそして今の安倍政権に対して大変な危機感を持っている国民の皆さんの期待に応えたいと思っています。
But at the same time, we must say that amongst the Japanese people, there are those people who are, well, the people will be forced to make a less worse choice. And I think that there are many Japanese people who oppose the LDP's reckless policies that they're taking. And therefore, I think that to the means possible, to the extent possible, where we do share our philosophies or certain policies to the extent possible, we have to try to collaborate so that we can get as many of our people elected in the election, and though that will be a tough challenge for us. So, and by doing so, we want to try to respond to the expectations of the people.
Thank you very much. I think this wraps up our event today. I'm sorry there's no time because they gave us only 5 minutes extension.I would like to extend 1 year honorary membership to our club. Thank you very much for coming. Please come here anytime. And as a journalist, I attended many of your events, and you opened the door to all journalists without registration. So we appreciate that in your party. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank
you.
Please remain seated until our guest leaves the room. Thank you very much for coming.
ありがとうございました。